Praise the Lord. Shall we pray? Our Father in heaven, we say thank you this morning for the gift of life. We appreciate you, King of Glory, for your faithfulness and your grace over our lives. We thank you, Lord Father, for a good night rest. We thank you for this day, a new day you have given us to be glad and rejoicing. We thank you for how you preserved and protected us. We thank you, Lord, for who you are and your faithfulness over our lives. And this day, Lord, we commit into your hands. This hour of prayer, we commit into your hands, O Lord. You said in your word, where two or three are gathered in your name, you're there. Our Father in heaven, we ask that you bless us with your presence this morning, as you have said. We ask that you bless us, O Lord, with a word, O Lord, that you speak to our hearts this morning. That you minister to us, O Lord, concerning the things that you have for us today. And we ask, O Lord, that you go ahead of us into today, O Lord, and make the crooked way straight for us in the name of Jesus. Father, we appreciate you. We bless you. Thank you for the things you do in our lives today. Let your name and your name be glorified. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen. Glory to God. Let's continue as we worship the Lord together this morning.
My foes are many, they rise against me, but I will hold my ground. I will not fear the war, I will not fear the storm. My help is on the way, my help is on the way. My refuge and strength always.
Never let me go.
Never let me go.
I lay it all down again.
I lay it all down again.
Just to hear you say that I'm your friend.
To hear you say that I'm your friend.
You are mine.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. We'll move to our general prayers this morning. And Brother Jesus will be leading us.
Amen. Amen. Praise the name of the living God. Praise the name of the living God.
Pick it up. Go ahead.
Let us pray. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, this morning, we just thank you, O God. We thank you, O God, that we can come in your presence, O God, the most precious and valuable presence, O God. Lord, you have invited us as your children into your presence, and you want to hear our voices this morning, O God. Lord, let our voices be like a sweet-smelling sacrifice unto you this morning, O God. Let our prayers rise up unto you, O God, even as the candle rises up, O God, in aroma unto you. We thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. People of God, saints of God, we are going to pray about kingdom service this morning. Kingdom service. And our first prayer is, Father, thank you for your mighty hand upon us that is sustaining the health and peace of our families. Father, thank you for your mighty hand upon us that is sustaining the health and peace of our family. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we bless and we worship you and we thank you, O God. We thank you that, Father, you are a good God. We thank you that your mighty hand is upon on us, oh God. And your mighty hand is sustaining the peace and health of our families, oh God. Father, I give you all that glory, oh God. I give you all the honor, oh God, that you have not allowed the fiery darts of the evil one to come near my family, oh God. Lord, you have created a shield of protection around my family, oh God. And this morning we say thank you, Jehovah. Thank you because you did it all by your hand, oh God. All by your power and your might and by your mercy and your grace, you have sustained our families, oh God. You have brought peace and health upon our families. And we say thank you in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We glorify, we magnify, we honor, we adore your holy name. Thank you in Jesus' name we pray. Now our prayer number two goes this way. We say, Father, we know that in Christ Jesus, we are delivered from every bondage of the devil. Therefore, Father, deliver us, our spirit, our souls, and body, freedom from the grip of darkness and from the influence of the evil one. Again, we say, Father, we know that in Christ Jesus, we are delivered from every bondage of the devil. Therefore, Father, deliver our spirit, soul, and body, freedom, oh God, from the grip of darkness and from the influence of the evil one. And we can read this morning from Psalm 34, verse 17. He says, the righteous cry, and the Lord heareth them, and delivereth them all of their troubles. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as be of a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them out of them all. He keepeth all his bones, not one of them is broken. Father, that is your word, O God. This morning, our prayer is that all the wrathful Father, we say, Father, Lord, Father, we know that in Christ Jesus we are delivered from every bondage of the devil. Therefore, Father, deliver us, O God, spirit, soul, and body, freedom from the grip of darkness, from the influence of the evil one. Deliver us, O Lord, from the influence of the evil one, O God. Help us, O God. Be our helper this morning, O God. Father, Lord, we know, we believe in Christ Jesus, that we are delivered from every bondage of the devil. Therefore, Father, deliver us, O God, our souls, our spirits, our bodies, O God. Yes, Lord, freedom. Give us freedom from the grip of darkness, O God, and from the influence of the evil one. We give you all the glory. We thank you. We bless you. We worship you, with God. Thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Now our prayer number three, we're saying, Father, empower us with grace for higher level of spiritual consecrations, thereby making us fit for your use in your kingdom, and establish the works of our hands greatly. Amen. In Jesus' name. Again, we say, Father, empower us, oh God, with the grace of higher levels of spiritual consecration, thereby making us fit for your use in your kingdom, and establish the works of my hand greatly, oh God. The word is greatly. Establish the works of my hands greatly, oh God. Lord, we thank you, oh God. Now we read from Psalm 27, verse 4. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that I will seek after, and that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to beautify the beauty, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. And Psalm 97 says, and let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us. Father, let the beauty of the Lord be upon us. Father, empower us with grace for higher level of spiritual consecration, thereby, oh God, making us fit for your use in your kingdom, and establish the works of my hands greatly in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, O God. And the Lord, and let the Lord, the beauty of the Lord our God, be upon us. Psalm 90, verse 7. And establish thou the works of our hands upon us. Yea, the works of our hands. Establish thou, dear God. Father, empower us, O God. Our hands are lifted up unto you, O God, O God. Empower us with grace for also for higher levels of spiritual consecration, thereby making us fit for your use in the kingdom. And establish, O Lord, establish the works of my hands in Jesus' mighty name. Prayer number four. Prayer number four, we are on number five now. Prayer number four, Father, let whatever face of the covering caster and veil spread over us, blocking our access to the light of the treasures of heaven, be destroyed and take away our reproach to be able to serve you without hindrance. Yes, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we say, Father, let whatever face of the covering caster, yes, and veil spread over us, blocking our access to the light of the treasures of heaven, be destroyed this morning, oh God, and take away our reproach to be able to serve you without hindrance. In Jesus' name, let us pray. Let us pray. Saint, let us pray. And we can read from Isaiah 25, verse 7. And he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all people, and the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death in victory. And the Lord God will wipe away tears from all our faces. And the rebuke of his people shall he take away from all of the earth. For the Lord has spoken it. Thank you, Lord Jesus God. Father, we cry unto you this morning. Let whatever face of the covering cast and veil spread over us, blocking our access to the light of the treasures of heaven, be destroyed and taken away, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Take away our reproach, O God, to be able to serve you without hindrance, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Lord, we just give you thanks. We thank you for answered prayers already. We give you all the glory in Jesus' name. Now our prayer number five says, Father God, give us a heart to know you, empowering us to be committed to you in true kingdom service like never, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, give us a heart. So Father, give us a heart to know you, empowering us to be committed to you in true kingdom service like never, in Jesus' mighty name. And we read from Jeremiah 24, verse 7, and I will give them an heart to know me, and I am that I am the Lord, and they shall be my people, and I will be their God. For they shall return unto me with their whole heart. Father, Lord, this morning our prayer is that, Father, give us a heart to know you, O God, empowering us to be committed to you in true kingdom service like never, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, fill our hearts with the love for your service, O God. Can you fill our hearts with the love for your kingdom service, O God? Empower us, O God, to be committed to you in true kingdom service, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ, O God. Just as you fill the heart of David, O God, and David loved you, O God. Lord, fill our hearts with that spirit of love for you, O God, that we will love to serve you, O God, that we will serve you with all our might and our spirit and our souls, O God. Oh, help us, Jehovah, that our kingdom service shall be acceptable unto you, O God, that you will be happy with the way we serve you, O God, because we know that, Lord, when a man's ways pleases you, O God, you bless him, O God, and even you make even his enemies to be at peace with him, O God. This morning, our prayer is that, Father God, give us a heart to know you, empowering us to be committed to you in true kingdom service like never before. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, our prayer number six, say, Father, rain mightily upon us on this platform, the rain of the Spirit for great manifestations of your power, resulting in a new wave of signs and wonders and mighty deeds, and you being glorified in our midst. Oh, Father, Lord, let us pray, people. Father, rain mightily upon us on this platform, the rain of the Spirit for great manifestations of your power, resulting in a new wave of signs and wonders and mighty deeds, and you alone being glorified in our midst. The Bible says in Acts chapter 10, verse 34, that he says how God anointed Jesus Christ with power and with the Holy Ghost, that he went about healing the sick and doing good, yes, and destroying the works of the devil, because God was with him. Now we say, Father God, rain upon us that same mighty power of God. Father, rain mightily upon us on this platform. The rain of the Spirit for great manifestations of your power, resulting in a new wave of signs and wonders and mighty deeds, and you alone, O God, being glorified in our midst, O God. Psalm 44, verse 6, for I will pour water upon him that is thirsty, and floods upon the dry ground. I will pour my spirit upon thy seed, and my blessing upon thine offspring. Oh, Father, rise up, O God. Rise up this morning, O God, and Lord, Lord Father, rain mightily upon us this, on this platform, this rain, the rain of the Spirit of God. Let everyone on this platform receive the rain this morning, oh God. Rain upon us the great, mighty manifestation of your power, oh God. Oh Lord, resulting in signs and wonders and miracles in our lives, oh God. Lord, turn our lives into living wonders, oh God. Let our lives glorify you, oh God. Let our lives bring glory unto you daily, oh God, by the manifestations of your power upon us, oh God. Oh Lord, pour out your rain mightily upon us, oh God. You said, when they're poor and needy needs water and there is none, and they cry upon you, you will pour out your rain upon them. You will turn their lives into rains of water. You will pour out rivers in the desert unto them, oh God. This morning we say, Father God, mightily rain down upon us this morning. Rain down the Spirit upon us upon this platform. The rain of the Spirit from great manifestations of your power, resulting in new waves of signs and wonders and miracles, oh God, in our lives, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, oh God. Oh, Father God, we trust in you, oh God. We believe in you, oh God. Jesus said on the last day of the Griffith, he said, come unto me, all you who thirst, and come and drink of me, and out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Lord, let rivers of living water flow out of us, oh God. Lord, fill us with that living water, that out of our belly shall flow rivers of living water, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, oh God. Rise up, oh my Lord and my God. We thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. Now our prayer number 7. We say, Father, as we go, give us a mouth and wisdom. Father, as we go, give us a mouth and wisdom, which all our adversaries shall not be able to gainsay nor resist. That we will be able to speak a word in season to the weary. Let the words of our mouth be filled with grace and seasoned with salt, that we may know how we ought to answer every man. Oh, Father, this is our prayer this morning. Luke chapter 21, verse 54. I will give you a mouth and wisdom, which all your adversaries shall not be able to gainsay or resist. It said, Luke 21, verse 15, for I will give you a mouth and wisdom, which all your adversaries shall not be able to gainsay or resist. We say, Father, this morning, give us that mouth, O God. Give us that mouth and wisdom, O God, which all our adversaries shall not be able to gainsay nor resist, O God, that we will be able to speak a word in season to the weary. Let the words of our mouths be filled with grace and seasons, with salt, seasoned with salt, that we may know how we ought to answer every man, O God. Oh, my Lord, rise up, O God. Father, touch our mouths, O God. Fill us with your spirit of wisdom and knowledge, O God. Your spirit of favor, O God. Fill us with your spirit of understanding, O God. Lord, give us wisdom, O God. Give us a mouth and wisdom, O God. Oh, which are irresistible, O God, that our adversaries shall not be able to gainsay nor resist, O God, that we will be able to speak a word in season to the weary. Oh, Lord, let the words of our mouths be filled with grace and seasoned with salt, that we may know what we ought to answer every man at every time, O God. Oh, my Lord and my God, Lord, give us that mouth and wisdom this morning, oh God. The word says, whoever lacks this will ask of you. Thank you in Jesus' name. Now our prayer number 8, we say, Father, put in us the zeal and the grace to be fruitful soul winners for your kingdom. Let us never go unconcerned for lost souls anymore in Jesus' name. Again, we say, Father, put in us the zeal, the burning zeal, the burning fire, oh God, and the grace to be fruitful soul winners for your kingdom. Let us never go unconcerned for lost souls anymore. In Jesus' mighty name, let us pray, people of God. For the zeal, Psalm 69, verse 9 says, for the zeal of thine house has eaten me up, and the reproach of them that reproach thee are falling upon me. Father, put in us this morning the zeal and the grace to be fruitful soul witness for your kingdom. Let us never go unconcerned for lost souls anymore in the name of Jesus Christ, God. Oh, Father God, help us, oh God, that lost souls, oh God, shall be our concern, oh God. Father, put in us that zeal, that burning fire, that strong desire, oh God, and give us the grace to be fruitful soul witness for your kingdom, oh God. Cause us, oh God, to be workers in your vineyard, oh God, bringing new souls unto you, oh God, pursuing new souls unto you, oh God. Let us never go unconcerned for more souls, oh God. Anymore, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, oh God. Fill us with your spirit, oh God. Give us that zeal, the zeal that you give unto Jesus Christ, oh God. Give us that same zeal, oh God. The zeal that Jesus Christ said, yes, now I do my Father's work. Force us to do your work. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your name. Hallelujah. We'll be reading from Psalm 46 this morning. Psalm 46, 1 to 11. Psalm 46, 1 to 11. And Brother Mensah will be reading for us.
Amen. Psalm 46, verses 1 to 11. God's defense of a city and people. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth shall change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam through the mountains, though the mountains tremble with its tumult. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city. It shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in an uproar, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord. See what desolation he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth.
Yes.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
Hallelujah.
The Lord.
Hallelujah. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Glory to God. The truth is this. God is here to help us. Or let me put it this way. God is here to help you. And you must recognize that. We're still on covenant positioning for help from above. You must recognize that. And I pray today God will help you. That scripture we just read says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. So no matter what the situation is, you have to see first that God is there to help you, not to trouble you, not to increase the trouble, but to help you. The problem, like I said before, is many of us don't reckon with that. We don't even see God there to help us. So we talk about trust yesterday. We are quick at going into other things first. When everything fails, then we now say, oh, where is God? Let me look for him. No, he's a very present help in trouble. Whatever you are going through right now is there to help you. And I'm trusting God that you'll be able to open up your eyes, see him, and call for his help today. Because until you receive, we've said that many times, the help of God, no man can help you. He said, Dinah, we, thou son of Jesse, and on thy side, because the Lord thy God helped thee. That's why we're here with you, because God helped you. And this Psalm 46 says, because God is your refuge. Now watch, it's our refuge. He said, therefore, will not we fear. I need you to hold that because we've talked on a few things in our positioning. We've talked on pride, that means directly talking on humility, talking on trust. Therefore, will not we fear? He said, would he have been removed? You can ask the question, David, what's going on? If he had this removed, where will you yourself be? Though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters roar out thereof and be troubled, everything is upside down. Everything, there is confusion and commotion. Everything is scattered. Nothing is working. He said, even at that, you must recognize in the midst of that commotion, in the midst of that confusion, recognize, he said, verse 4, there is a river. That there is something to start with. What is it? A river. The streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. Therefore, we will not fear because we know that God is there. We know that his provision of help is there. We know God is there. That river talks of the life-giving presence and power of God that flows everywhere. If you can't see it, then you can look up to him. You must see it. In the midst of it all, never give up, never be discouraged. See him there with you. He's the helper of our destinies. He's our helper. In the midst of everything, God is there to help you. But you must see it. Isaiah 50 says it in this way, verse 7. He said, but the Lord God will help me. Therefore, I shall not be confounded. The Lord God will help me. I know it. Therefore, I'm not going to be terrified. I'm not going to go about jumping from place to place and wondering what's going to happen. No, the Lord, because the Lord God will help me. Therefore, I shall not be confounded. He said, therefore, I have set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be ashamed. Connection to health from above is what enhances our dignity here on earth. We must know how to connect. And when you put these two verses and the rest I'm talking together, he said, therefore, we will not fear. The Lord God will help me, therefore, I shall not be confounded. That brings me to our third point. In positioning ourselves correctly, which is stillness. He said, for God is in the midst of us. That's verse 5. Verse 4 said, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High, because God is in the midst of us. That's why I will not fear. That's why I will not be confounded. That is why I will not be jumping about time looking as if there is no hope. No, I know he's there. There is a river. The streams where I shall make glad. It will turn situations around for me because God is in the midst of us. If you know that, then you'll be still. You will not be confounded. You will not fear. No matter what is going on, see God there as your helper. So be still. Hallelujah. Be still. In fact, that's why it went down in Psalm 46, down the line, I think the second to the last verse thereabout. It says, be still and know that I am God. That's what God is ever saying. Stop fidgeting, stop pondering, stop wondering, stop being afraid, stop shooking yourself somewhere. He said, be still and know that I am God. He said, in your situation, I will be exalted among the heathen. In your situation, I will be exalted in the heart. Stillness is an act of faith. It is not that of inaction. It is actually an act of faith. It is faith itself in action. It's an act that borders on your trust in him. Remember, Moses said it to them in Exodus 14, verse 13. And Moses said unto the people, fear ye not. And they saw the Egyptians who are behind them, looking ferocious with all their arms and implements of war. The Red Sea was before them. There was no way to go. That was death staring them in the face. And Moses said, fear ye not. Stand still. Not stand still doing nothing. No. Stillness is an act of faith in God. It's the manifestation of your trust in God. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will show you today. He said, for these Egyptians whom you have seen today, you shall see them again no more forever. Stand ye still. If you want God to fight for you, you can't be fighting. Two of you can't be fighting at the same time. He said it to them in Chronicles. You shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourself, position yourself correctly. You see, that's all we're talking about. That's how you position yourself with God. And stand ye still and see the salvation of the Lord with you. Fear not. It's nothing to be afraid of. I tell people, they say they will kill you tomorrow. Don't die today. That will be suicide. Suicide. Let tomorrow come. Let's see that tomorrow. Our God, whom we serve, they said, is able to deliver us, and he will deliver us. Stand ye still. What is that that is choking you? What is that that is making your heart pump with fear? Relax. There is a river. The streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. Therefore, she shall not be moved. And God shall help her, and that right early. His help comes at the right time. Your timing may be wrong, because no, God is never in a hurry. He that believeth shall not make haste, because he's so sure the help of God will answer. Stand still. The next thing to do, just to wrap that one up this week, is then call for his help. Call unto me and I will answer you. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Call for help. God, help me. Simple prayer, but the most powerful. All Judah gathered together to seek help of the Lord, 2 Chronicles tells us. Help me, O my Father. You are the helper of the helpless. Call for his help. And call boldly, call humbly, call believing, knowing that he's there. And I go quickly to the last one. And when you've done it, praise him for it. Just keep praising him. They went off. And when they began to sing and to dance, they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set ambushment, the Bible says, against their enemies. It takes the help of God to go up, reaching to meet God's people. It also takes his help to stay up. You will keep going up in life. Praise him. How do we do that? Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. If you need his help, come with thanksgiving. Praise him. Be thankful unto him. Bless his name. If you want to find help in the time of need, you need to know how to reach for your helper. That's all we've talked about this week. Know how to connect with your helper. Know how to approach him correctly. Glory to God. He said, and all Judah gathered themselves together to seek help of the Lord. You can seek his help. He is your help. Is there for you to help you. God is our refuge and strength. No matter the commotion, no matter the devastation, no matter the corruption, no matter the evil, no matter how far you think it has gone, there is nothing irrecoverable by him. No matter what, seek for his help today. And that you have a great opportunity this time, this morning, to seek for his help. As we go before him, our personal moment with God, as we go before him, seek his help. Oh God of my Father, help me. You are the helper of the helpless. Lord, help me. Help me. Make a way for me. You go before the Lord. You say, I put my trust in you. They that know thy name will put their trust in you, because you have never been known to disappoint them, the scripture says. I know you don't disappoint. I know you will not disappoint me. I put my trust in you. Blessed is that man who puts his trust in God, whose hope the Lord is, the Bible says. Connect with him this morning. Say, the Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend you. send you help from his sanctuary and strengthen you out of Zion. Ask for his help and he will send you help. The psalmist says, oh Lord, my God, make haste to help me. Make haste to help me. Help is available for you this morning. But notice, Job tells us, behold, God will not cast away a perfect man, neither will he help the evildoers. Correct positioning, therefore. Open up yourself before the Lord this morning, and his help will reach you. Quickly, he said, make haste to help me. His help is ever present. Take help from above this morning. Take help from above this morning. Glory to God. Now let's go before the Lord with our personal moments. Hallelujah. Let's go before the Lord with our personal moment to seek help of him, to receive help of him. This is that time. Seek his help. Receive his help. Call for his help. His help is available for you. Say, Lord, help me. Hallelujah. Help me, O God. I put my trust in you. Over to you, God's people. Let's go before the Lord and take help of the Almighty this morning. We'll be back together shortly. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh, may the Lord of heaven hear your cry for help this morning. Amen. There's a river. The streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. Because God is in the midst of that river. That's what makes it. And it's flowing your way this morning. It's flowing your way this morning. Glory to God. Never you stop calling for his help. That's why he's there. And because we have called this morning, I know you have received his help. He will help you. He said, the Lord God will help me. Therefore, I shall not be confounded. For the Lord God will help me. I have set my face like a flint. I know I shall not be disappointed. You will not be disappointed. Because God is your helper. He's heard your voice of your cry of help this morning. And I know his help is set your way already. So keep thanking him for help from above. Keep celebrating him for his help. He said, he is near that justifies me. Yeah. Who is he that will contend with me? God has justified you. Who is he that will contend? That means he's marked you right. Who will say you are failed? He's near that justifies me. Who is he that will contend with me? He said, let us stand together. Who is my adversary? Let him come near to me because God is with me. Show up if you can dare it. The help of God is on your side. Oh, the Lord, he said, behold, the Lord God will help me. Who is he that shall condemn me? They will disappear without notice. The help of God is yours. Enjoy that help. Celebrate it. Rejoice in it. Stand ye still and you shall see. That help is yours already. Whatever that situation is, the help of God is yours. And you are coming out of it gloriously because his life-giving presence has come your way. Glory to God. Father, we thank you this morning. Thank you for the release of help. Thank you for sending us help. Say, we'll send you help from the sanctuary. Strengthen you out of Zion. Glory to your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. What a great week we've had in his presence. Glory to God. Remember, this program runs Monday through Fridays. We'll be back on this platform Monday. And next week, we are having an interesting manifestation of God's people here, giving us his word from every experience and encounter they've had with God. And it's going to be great. Jesus is Lord. So have a most fruitful weekend. And I mean it. Most fruitful weekend. Most relaxing, in which nothing troubles you. He said, in nothing terrified by your adversaries. Where is your accuser? Where is he condemning you? That will be the question, because they will not be found. He said, they shall wax as old. They shall wax old as a garment, and the moth shall heat them up. Why? Because the Lord thy God has chosen to help you. Glory to God. Enjoy his help. Testify of his help, because he's on your side. He said, thine are we, thou son of Jesse, and on thy side, because the Lord thy God helpeth thee. He's turning it for you by his hand. His help is turning it for you. So celebrate him for it. Yes, hallelujah. I'm excited for you because God's help has located you and he's turning it. So we'll be back here Monday morning, 5 a.m. Mountain Time. As usual, glory to God. Enjoy your part as you go. Let it keep dropping fatness for you as you go. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, the Most Holy One. We give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name. Have a great weekend. And the favor of the Almighty speaking for you. In the name of Jesus. Let's share the goodness together this morning. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. See you again on this platform Monday morning in your exalted state. Jesus is Lord.